12e, le Belge Noah Loez, le 289, qui s'est fait titiller juste en sortie du pif-paf des deux chaînes. C'est la raison pour laquelle ce pilote belge a rétrogradé. Et puis Hichem Mazou, le 243, termine 13e. 14e, Lorenz, Gus Lorenz. Et Benjamin Davis, le 345, 15e.
So Jean-Baptiste Chara won with 3.666. Second gap to Oliver Hodgson in second position. So it's a good race for the Brit, who could resist to the pressure set by Jordan Braun Nutley, who is an eventual third. Marco Paul for Germany comes home in fourth ahead of Sébastien Gibier, who did a great effort to recover from 12th on the grid. In P6, Vincent Marceau of the VDK Racing Team. Seventh position for François-Xavier Venet, who last year won 4 out of 6 heats in this competition and fought for the podium finish in the final. Henke Waldschmidt, who was here in Le Mans with the CRG SPA factory team 1 month ago. He's back in Le Mans to try to contest this Yamaha International Final and maybe aim for a top 10 or top 5 or podium finish. So congratulations, Henke, for coming back to Le Mans for another major race. That's 8th position for Henke. Gary Edwards is in P9. Tom Ledo is in P10. That's the top 10 for this X30 senior class for the series C and F.
Ce sont des juniors, c'est les CF qui sont en pré-grille. Une pré-grille qui est occupée en première ligne avec Kylian Meyer, le numéro 4, et Morgan Porter, le 46. En seconde ligne, nous avons Louis Westover, le 161, et Jack Mebin, le 171. À la troisième ligne, Gillian Orion, le 33, et Anthony Famularo, le 82. Nous avons la quatrième ligne, Axel Laflamme, le 157, et Vascalis Kasparas, le 54. En cinquième ligne, Max Jeanne, le 21, et Franck Chappard, le 134. En sixième ligne, Thomas Mialan, le 26, et Levi Litucanto, le numéro 16. À la septième ligne, Alessandro Giretti, le numéro 9. Aux côtés d'Alessandro, il y a Kyle Connolly, le 150. En huitième ligne, Anders Rosenkild Hansen, le 108. Antoine Potti, le 66, l'y accompagne. Sont à la 9e ligne, Lewis Thompson, le 79, et Yvon Beretz, le 11. 10e ligne avec Royce Yu, le 35, et Karl Langtoff, le 169. Alors que nous avons bien 16 lignes, avec dans cette 16e ligne, Karl Etemedzian, le 180, et Jay Corey, le 185.
il y a deux de nos photographes préférés de la proximité de la Prairie. Il y a Jacques Foulatier et Tino Cacopardo. Voilà, ils vont reprendre leur place préférée sur ce circuit pour fixer sur la pellicule, dans les pixels.
Là, je vais leur dire.
Cliché, voilà. Et ben voilà, coucou Tino et coucou au pilote de la première ligne. So the first tour of the grid with Kilian Mayer, who comes from Spain and drives a CRG, like he did in the Euro Series, in which he finished in third position on the podium. Next to him on number 46, driver Morgan Porter from the UK. And then Louis Westhoven, number 161, will be on the second row alongside Jack Maybin. Row 3 for Gillian Henrion, the first, the best placed French driver on this grid. Gillian Henrion, the French champion of the cadet class last year, number 82. Anthony Famularo from Venezuela and Axel Laflamme, number 157, comes from the UK. Alongside Axel comes Vaskelis Kasparas, Max Jan and Frank Schaparcher, the row 5 of this grid. So it's going to be a 7-lap race, as usual for the juniors, age 13 to 15 years old, 13 à 15 ans pour les juniors, et un moteur qui fait 20 chevaux. There is a restrictor at the exhaust to limit the power to 20 bhp for the junior engine. This is exactly the same engine as in the X30 Senior, but of course there is the restrictor for a little less power. There is no front brakes on this chassis. This is a international standard chassis, of course, agreed by with the approval of the CIK FI. So we are about to start this race with a Spanish pole sitter, Kilian Mayer, and Morgan Porter. So let's see who is going to be the fastest, the swiftest driver heading to turn one. So let's have a look at the lights, and they're switched off. So let's see if Kilian Mayer, with a crash helmet with the colors of Spain, yes, he's able to lead the pack in this first corner. And there's a,
oh là là,
there's
là
a
cette
major
fois-ci
clash.
Ouh là 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 là.
Yeah, many drivers were,
oh,
involved
le,
in
le
the crash,
crash,
I'm afraid, de Jean-Pierre.
Oh là 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 là. Là, ils étaient quand même pas mal dans ce tas. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 pilotes, 15 pilotes.
So it's the slow procedure with the yellow flag waved at each marshal post. So the marshals all run circuit and waving the yellow flag, and the slow board is shown in the main straight by the race direction. So the drivers will slow down, of course, no overtaking maneuver permitted, and then we'll wait for the green flag. For the moment, drivers have to run slowly around the track. Fortunately, we have two drivers of the VDK squad involved in this clash that happened just exiting turn one. So of course the laps completed under the slow procedure count towards the race, so the leader. So the leader is still Kilian Meyer after one lap. He's about to complete second lap, still in the slow under slow procedure. Kilian Meyer and Louis Westover in second position from third on the grid. Gillian Orion went from fifth to third, and Axel Laflamme is in P4, ahead of Morgan Porter.
Alors la course continue bien sûr, mais elle est maîtrisée par le drapeau jaune et les panneaux slow, donc interdiction de doubler. Ouais. Ouais, ouais, parce que là il y en avait un qui était prêt de doubler déjà, un autre pilote qui était à côté de lui. Procédure slow, c'est tout le monde les uns derrière les autres à vitesse réduite.
So the slow procedure continues, and we are now approaching the third lap. We will complete the third lap, and the unlucky drivers, Jean-Pierre, are Alessandro Ghiretti, Lewis Thompson, Yvan Beretz, and Roy Sue. I'm afraid we have four retirements in this race. Il y a quatre abandons, malheureusement, Jean-Pierre, dans cette course.
Bah oui, malheureusement, c'est dommage. Il y a eu un sacré pataquès, ça. Et malheureusement, il y a toujours des victimes. Alors que...
driver in trouble is number 21, I'm afraid. 21 was the driver who started from ninth position. It's Max Jeanne, number 21, so from the Isle of Jersey, to Litchfield Motorsport driver, the beloved Tony Cards, in trouble in during this slow procedure. So I see the green flag, which means that we are racing in Le Mans again with Kilian Meyer leading the pack and Louis Westover, who is just behind the Spanish driver. So we have a Spanish and a British and a French with Julian Orion in third position. So this is lap number 5. So just three laps to go, or maybe two laps to go. I don't know exactly. No, that's 4 laps completed. So we have to complete 7 laps in this race, champion.
C'est Thomas Mialan qui est immobilisé dans la ligne droite du chemin Aubeux. Alors que c'est l'Espagnol Kilian Meyer, le numéro 4, qui est en première position devant le Britannique Louis Westover, le 161. Julian Orion est à la troisième position toujours, suivi par le Britannique Axel Laflamme, le 157, alors que nous avons de nouveau l'agitation des drapeaux jaunes au niveau de la direction de course. Et oui, un pilote est immobilisé dans la courbe. Et ce doit être le 75 d'ailleurs.
So it's a yellow flag race because we have yellow flags waved by the officials in the main straight because drivers are stopped outside the turn one. So drivers have to be careful, of course, no overtaking. But Julian Meyer doesn't have anyone to overtake because he's leading the race with Julian Orion up to P2. Julian Orion qui passe en deuxième position. So he's up to P2 and overtook Louis Westover somewhere. So the new top three.
C'est le sixième avant-dernier tour qu'effectuent ces pilotes actuellement, toujours emmenés par par l'Espagnol Kilian Meyer, ce numéro 4 qui avait 5 dixièmes d'avance sur le Français Julian Orion. C'est toujours d'actualité actuellement. Derrière Julian Orion, il ne me semble pas que ce soit Louis Westover, mais peut-être Jack Mabin, qui est à la troisième position, la quatrième pour Louis Westover.
And Mabin is up to, was up to P3 and now up to P2. Jack Mabin overtook Julian Orion, so after overtaking Westover, now the British driver is in second position, and this is the last lap of the race. We've had most of the race completed under yellow flag conditions, slow zone and slow procedure. So now we have to finish this race with just this single lap to determine the final classification. So it's Kilian Meyer who led from the start, who is still leading the race, but of course Jack Mabin is fast in this in closing stages. So is he going to be able to close to the leader? We will see.
C'est le dernier tour, pas de changement concernant la première position. Seconde position, il y a eu un changement bien sûr, c'est le Britannique Jack Mabin, le 171 qui l'occupe avec en troisième position le Français Julian Olay. Quatrième position, nous avions Westover, la flamme cinquième.
So this is the finish of this race with a Spanish victory taken that takes Julian Meyer with Jack Mabin in second and Julian Orion, the French driver, in third. Fourth position for Axel Laflamme, number 157. It's another British racer. Number 161, Louis Westover, who started from the second row of the grid, so he's an eventual fifth. He fought hard, but he lost a couple of places. Anthony Famularo from Venezuela, what a long journey, come here and race with us in Le Mans. And so he's in P6 ahead of Livi. Lin Tukanto from Finland, Vaskelis Kasparas from Lithuania, Antoine Petit from Belgium, and Jack Duan. Jack Duan once again has recovered from P24 to P10. Congratulations to the son of the 5-time world champion of the motorbike 500cc class. He came all the way from Australia to conquer 10th position.